I am live. Hello. Hello, everyone. Welcome. Welcome. Welcome once again to a completely impromptu Why Not live stream from me, your Judge John Hodgman, during this, the hashtag MaxFunDrive. You may notice a ticker tape at the bottom of the screen, a chyron, if you will, reminding you that this is day two of the 2 weeks of the Maximum Fun Drive, the 2 weeks of the year where we invite you to enjoy being a member of the Maximum Fun community by going to MaximumFun.org/join. I named this one Max Fun Judge John Hodgman Family Meeting because I'm going to be joined by two very important members of the Judge John Hodgman family here at Maximum Fun. In a moment, I believe. Nice to see you here in the chat. Oh, here comes someone right now. I wonder who's at the door. Ding dong. Oh, it's Jesse Thorne.
Hey, pal. How's it going?
Good. How are you?
I'm doing all right. You know, just hanging out with my giant paperclip I bought at the flea market.
Whoa.
See, look how giant it is. That's not foreshortening.
What kind of papers are you going to clip together? Some massive papers?
Just like standard size papers.
Standard
just like
size.
Just some mail, you know.
Also, you're wearing that cool T-shirt from that comic book, Concrete.
Yeah. Have you read that comic book?
Not since then. I loved it, though.
I was going to say, it seems like a comic book you would have read in 1989.
Yeah, that's exactly right. Did you read it?
Yeah, my friend Stefan Lawrence from Elephant Larry, the great sketch comedy group, who's also the husband of Max Fun host Biz Ellis from One Bad Mother. Years ago, I just said to him, hey, what comic books should I read? And he suggested this one, and I really like it. I liked how it was a little boring,
mm-hmm.
and just about what if there's no grand scale? It's just like, what if a guy became a superhero, but he just wanted to read a book at the bottom of the ocean?
It's, you know, it's more and more appealing to me every day. Hey, yeah. We've got another member of the Judge John Hodgman family at the door, ding-donging away. Here we go. It's, come in. There's Jennifer
Ding dong,
Marmor.
It's me.
Producer Jennifer Marmor is here. Many people.
Hello.
You know, look, this is going out live to all the old familiar places. The Facebook, the long-standing Facebook group for Judge John Hodgman. You've been our rocks. You've been our concretes for so long. Also going out to my old platform page, my Twitch page, my personal YouTube page, and also our brand new Judge John Hodgman YouTube channel, which has been, thanks to you, Jennifer, and to Daniel Spear, has been tearing it up with those live-to-tape episodes. People get to see my face and Jesse's face in costume now when we do the show. But they still probably, but a lot of them, oh yeah, our cute suits, of course, but a lot of them have maybe never seen you. And someone in there wants to point out the love that Jennifer's headphones and glasses match. And that's our friend Perry Von Vicious, the professional wrestler. Hey, Perry, what's up?
One day I was wearing a pink jumpsuit with these headphones and glasses, and I realized it like halfway through the day, and I felt really silly, like a person who's obsessed with the color pink.
That way you're ready for professional wrestling.
Yeah, you just got a compliment from a professional wrestler, and Perry, you just won a big championship belt too.
Which
Perry. Yeah. So I want to learn more about that. And I said that this is totally impromptu. We were just recording some fun stuff for the podcast, and I was like, let's go live. Mm-hmm. And I called it Judge John Hodgman Family Meeting. If there are other members of the Judge John Hodgman family out there, maybe you're a former litigant, a guest bailiff. Sorry. Lost my mind for a second. Got it
back.
John,
I know one member of the Judge John Hodgman family that is here and available.
All right,
to join us on this live stream.
Let them know. Hang on one second.
How am I going to?
Oh, here. Right. You introduce them to Junior while I get something going on over here. Wow, Zally, this is great. Oh, wow. Jennifer, you talk to Junior. So we get. I want to get Junior some more camera space. So I'm gonna dip out for a second. I'm gonna get something going here.
Okay. This isn't get your pets because I'm not John. But hi, Junior.
Hi.
He what says. A dog.
I adopted Junior right around Christmas time, and as some Judge John Hodgman listeners probably know, my very longtime dog Coco passed away about a year ago.
Yeah.
And we missed her so bad, and I never knew if I could ever have another dog, frankly. Mm-hmm. Even Sissy, the dog that already lived in my house, I thought about making her live on a different floor or something.
Yeah.
And then around Christmas time, just shortly after Christmas, my wife said, do you want to look on Pet Finder? And I was looking for dogs that were scruffy but very different from Coco.
And yes.
I found this. I found this big chunky boy, 45 pounds in Chino Hills, which is an anonymous suburb of Los Angeles. And I went to a special like storefront adoption place to meet him. His name was Jax. And I know. And I went there and I'm like waiting in this line and I'm like, this is crazy. Why is there a line to adopt a dog? And then, this man came to like take my name. This woman came to take my name. And she goes, and what dog are you here to see? I said, Jax. And she said, oh, you're not here to see a puppy? And I'm like, no. And she's like, go ahead on in.
Oh, wow.
So Junior was an unwanted grown up.
I can't believe that.
It turns out that he is probably kind of a puppy. He's probably like 10 months or something. But when I went in there, it was like a little narrow hallway with little dog rooms. Mm-hmm. And there was two dogs in each of the little tiny dog rooms.
Mm-hmm.
And, you know, like little kennelly sized rooms.
Sure, sure, sure.
And she said, we're a little bit in overflow right now. So you might notice that he's in a closet. So she opened the closet door. It was like the supply closet. And he was in there. And he was so excited that we came in that he literally jumped off of the walls, off the walls, and peed on my shoes and started licking me. And I said, uh-oh.
That's how you know.
I might bring home a stinker. But he's a real champ.
Oh, look at
him.
He's a sweet dog.
What a wonderful scruffy muzzle.
You got to pet him, Jen, in the office today.
Yeah.
I didn't get to pet him. I never got to pet him.
I'm in the office right now, and he like jumped right up on my lap, and his face was right here, and it was very sweet. Very sweet.
He surprises strangers on the street with his friendliness. It's a real problem. It's like Junior, the biggest challenge. His biggest, he also eats poop. But the two biggest problems are...
We all do from time to time.
Yeah. At the end of the day.
Yeah.
It's interesting. It's compelling. What's going on there?
Yeah. There's a lot. There's a lot to think about.
But his biggest problem is that he wants to be best friends with every single person that we walk past on the street. And sometimes there are little old ladies who are surprised that a golden retriever is jumping at their butts.
Now, let me explain to Junior what's happening here.
Yeah.
This is the second day of the rest of your Max Fun Drive. It's the 2 weeks a year when we ask you, the listeners and fans of Judge John Hodgman, to consider becoming a member of Maximum Fun if you are not already, and if you are a member, to perhaps upgrade or boost your membership in order to keep our lights on and keep Junior fed with kibble, keep Jennifer Marmor and her family's lights on, and to keep her producing the show so perfectly, and to keep Jesse and me able to continue to make the show. I'm really doing good at pointing. And it all happens because of your support. 70% of all of our budget comes from memberships, monthly memberships like yours, maybe. And the baseline membership is $5 a month. And you can go become one at MaximumFun.org/join and get kind of gifts and fun stuff. But most of all, you get to support the show. And we're just doing a quick family meeting here, talking to Jesse, talking to producer Jennifer, talking to Junior. Hey, it's all Jays once again.
John, can I tell you something?
Minus Joel.
Yeah, minus Joel.
Yeah, Joel.
But we have Jesse Jr. here, so that's two J's.
JJ. Yeah, and look, I don't know. We're live now over our brand new YouTube channel at Judge John Hodgman Pod at YouTube. smash that like, subscribe and share button. But someone get to Joel Mann and tell him to join the meeting. Because if you're a member of the Judge John Hodgman family,
good boy, Joel.
I've just put a link up there, which is bit.ly/JJHOFamMeet. And there are instructions for how to enter the waiting room. So if you're a former litigant, if you're a bailiff, let's say you're a professional wrestler in Western Massachusetts, why don't you join the conversation? Just go to, just follow those directions right there. I'm not going to repeat them, and maybe
John,
we'll see you there.
Yeah, I'm seeing a couple of comments I want to address. First of all, I see a comment from A. Beth G., who says, thinking of upgrading. If there has ever been a comment that begs for us to directly address it, so you get a little bit of extra attention, Beth G., you should upgrade.
Yeah.
I'm glad to do it. I'm glad to give you the attention here. No problemo. 100% thrilled to do it.
Now, let me just explain. Let's say A. Beth G. is a member, right?
Yeah.
Maybe A. Beth G. is a member at $5 a month. And at $5 a month, A. Beth G. not only gets to support the show, but gets all of the members-only bonus content. Unfortunately, no members-only jackets. Just incredible bonus content, hundreds of hours of fun stuff. To upgrade would mean jumping to, say, the $10 a month level, at which point A. Beth G. unlocks for themselves a beautiful enamel pin that says friend of the court that will allow A. Beth G. to be recognized as a friend of the judge, court of Judge John Hodgman, wherever they may go. And there's all kinds of different swag at every level of membership if you were to upgrade. But you don't have to upgrade to a second level of membership in order to support us. You can just boost us with a couple of bucks. All there at maximumfund.org/join.
Yeah, somebody asked how they upgrade their... The fake Denise asks how to upgrade their membership. And the answer is maximumfund.org/join, just like everything else. You'll find the instructions right there. It's very quick and easy. A. Beth G. is already a member. She's thinking about kicking it up to 20 a month.
Keep do thinking. Less thinking, more doing, A. Beth G. Yeah. No, we love you no matter what. Thank you so much for being a member. Now, Thank you. Our friend who used to live in the Azores and then moved, and then I believe moved to Salt Lake City, asks, does being a Swift Justice litigant count as being a formal litigant? Yes. So, Kate, you know how to join. I'm sure you've got that incredible Wi-Fi out there in Salt Lake.
Please join. I have a million questions about Salt Lake City, and they all involve Real Housewives.
Oh, there we go.
Oh, wow.
Ponce,
I don't have
Salt
to
Lake
drag
City
you
with...
down there.
Let's have a round of applause for Ponce City Marxist, please. Ugh, fine, I'll join. Like, absolutely. And also...
I think Ponce City Marxist was inspired by the fact that they have the same mechanical keyboard I have.
Yeah, that's true.
A mechanical keyboard for the people.
I've only been to Salt Lake City one time. I went with my dad on a road trip when I was like 12. The main thing that I remember is that like the coolest shit only Mormons are allowed to go into. And I was like, oh, I want to go in there. Yeah. So let's get some, you know what? If we went now, we could go to one of those soda pop drive-thrus.
There we go.
Hey, there's a member of the Maxon family at the, Maxon family and Judge John Hodgman family at the door. Former Swift Justice litigant and former Azorean resident, Kate. Hi, Kate. How are you? Uh-oh, Kate, you're muted.
Oh, sorry. You think I'd be
there
better
she is. By
now. No, you're terrific. Kate, do I remember correctly that you moved from the Azores to Salt Lake City?
Yep. And I've used...
Oh, no. What a big sigh.
No, it's great. I've used a lot of your suggestions. We went and saw the Gagal sculpture.
My suggestions?
Yeah, you sent a tweet out and then you did a thing.
Oh, yeah. They weren't my... I mean, I facilitated suggestions for you, I suppose. But it's not like I know. I've never been to Salt Lake City.
The JJHO family suggestions.
That's right. The JHO fam.
Yeah. A lot of my family's big fan of the soda drive-thrus that Jesse mentioned.
Oh, yeah,
they have the good ice, from what I understand.
I don't drink soda, but everybody loves it.
Yeah, I mean, it's terrible for you, and you shouldn't drink it. That's my recommendation. But if there's a soda drive-thru, you should try that one time, because apparently they'll mix the flavors up different ways for you, or whatever.
They'll add, like, milk or half and half. Or
they do that everywhere. Like, even just, like, the restaurants have soda cocktails.
Wow. Yeah.
I love the prevalence of, I don't know, we used to call it a suicide, Oh, when you mix all the sodas together.
Right.
Oh, yeah.
Mm-hmm. Yeah, I support that. And honestly, while I don't understand why the milk doesn't curdle, I do support milk and soda. It sounds great to me. And I sometimes will drink those yogurt sodas that they drink in East Asia.
I know the rules of family meeting is that we don't interrupt each other, but I just have this to share.
Yeah.
iReal2. Oops, that's not it. Sorry, but thank you, iReal2. This is it.
That I was
Krabby Abby Games. I just supported after thinking about it for years.
Thank you, Krabby Abby.
Krabby Abby Games.
Thank you.
I don't know about those Krabby Abby Games. I bet they're great. Maybe someone better check them out. But iReal2 was saying I'm watching on both platforms from two browsers to boost the algorithm, and that helps too. Kate, you're on Twitch.
Yeah.
Now, I'm just curious here because you know I'm always trying to boost the algorithm and figure out how people are getting this stuff. Did you get a notification from Twitch that this was happening, or were you just happen to be online watching people do speed runs of Mario Kart or whatever?
I saw it on Facebook, actually.
Oh, okay.
I was checking Facebook for something else, which was out of character for me, and I happened to see it. I signed up for notifications on Twitch.
Mm-hmm.
This morning, I missed you completely. But the only reason I have Twitch is because of you, and like I'm not I don't have Instagram or Twitter or any of that.
So. Good. I'm glad that we can do this service for you, of bringing you into this nightmare world.
last year I did a fair amount of streaming for Max Fun Drive. It was a lot of fun. I got to know Kate very well at that time, or, you know, relatively well for someone that I've never met. And, but it was always on these exotic platforms, Twitch, like a little, one little tweet or whatever it was. I'm happy to report we got the big time. YouTube. Judge John Hodgman Pod on YouTube is our central place to go for Judge John Hodgman video content. It'll still go out to all the places where you've seen it before, but let the word go out, especially during Max Fun Drive. I'll be doing live streaming all these 2 weeks and doing all kinds of fun meetups and stuff like this to keep the Max Fun Drive going. But that's where we are now posting our live, or excuse me, not our live, but our video episodes. The whole episode, we're videotaping them, editing them together with Daniel Spear, putting them on YouTube. You can watch as well as listen. And we wouldn't be able to do it without the funds that are provided through this Max Fun Drive.
Can I say something?
Please.
I'm so excited that we're in video form now. I'm wondering if anybody in the comments has been watching the video episodes and what you think, because we've been posting all the video episodes up on the YouTube channel. I also just want to mention, I'm really glad we've got the video in addition to the audio, and you guys are really glad that we don't have odor in addition to the video and audio, because Junior just gave me a very special gift.
Oh, no.
Oh.
Junior farted?
Toots McGee.
Your dog reminds me of the dog that we picked up in the Azores.
Oh.
It was also really hard for me because I had to say goodbye to my dog, and it was a forced integration from the universe, and it actually ended up working out really well.
Oh, that's really sweet.
Sorry to hear that.
Yeah, but he's got this like same sort of demeanor that your dog has. And I always wonder, how are they so nice? Like, how are they so loving to humans? And like, why? Like, because theoretically, these rescue dogs that haven't been shown love shouldn't be as good as they are. And yet they're so good.
Did you know that genetic evidence suggests, I learned this from watching a B-minus documentary on Netflix, but do you know genetic evidence? Oh my goodness. Did you know genetic evidence suggests that floppy-eared dogs are the friendlier?
Oh, well, that would explain it.
Yeah. We got floppers. We both got floppers. Dusty, you did great. Dusty was wondering if, since they joined on March 1st, they did badly. No. You did wonderfully. You did wonderfully.
Good job, Dusty B58.
You know, I had to do something this year with the drive that I've never done before, but I've sort of topped out my membership, so I had to sign up my husband so that I could start the swag tiers again.
Wow. Yeah,
I kept mine, too. I boosted mine, but like...
Thank you, Kate.
Thank you so much.
In a couple of years, we're going to have to sign up Warble.
PFD Otter says, I had no idea what you look like, Jesse, and now, thanks to video, you do. Also, video got the judge busted. For years, we've been led to believe he is putting the guesses down in his guest book. No, I just, when I say I'm putting in the guest book, I do this. I shouldn't even do this. But it's just
it's interesting to me every time when you do that, because you do that.
I do. I just pretend that I'm writing something down. I don't even know. It's a joke that no one understands.
Sometimes we add in writing sound effects, but maybe that's why.
AI. Oh my God, or whatever. AI is here.
Yikes.
That's the one of the big names of the year. AI is here. Can't believe AI is here.
Taking a break from the cover of Time magazine.
Says, I can't wait to see video episodes when you try new foods. I think that's a reference to our annual, now semi-annual, semi-tradition of eating Christmas, weird Christmas foods together. Hey, you may not have to wait that long.
I thought it was just a reference to all video content on YouTube.
Yeah, right. But if you want some Max Fun specific eating food on video content, you might not have to wait that long. All I'm doing is make sure that you stay tuned to all of the live streams and the very special episodes that we're releasing on of the podcast in this Max Fun Drive. We've got a great one coming up. We got a really great one coming up on Wednesday, which is tomorrow. Preview. It's about a person who flushes soup down the toilet. And then next week we have a very special guest and an announcement about something that might be happening on Max Fun Drive if you support us at maximumfun.org/join. And also, you should know, thanks for hanging in there, Kate. Abeth G says, I'm hoping to see at least one peach at the Brooklyn meetup this week. That's a reference to the Max Fun meetup at Stu Wellington's bar at
Hinterlands.
At Hinterlands, right? They have
two. I think it's at Minnie's.
Oh, it's at Minnie's.
Yeah, let me.
Why don't you check that out, Jennifer Marmor, while
that's Charlene's right bar. Mrs. Stuart Wellington and a whole person in her own right.
Now, this person I don't think has ever been a litigant, but I consider him to be part of the Judge John Hodgman family because he lifted me over his shoulders once in a wrestling move. It's Perry Von Vicious, the famous Western Massachusettsian and now Japanese market professional wrestler. Hey, Perry, how are you doing?
Hi, good. Good to see you.
Have you met Kate?
I don't believe I've met anyone here but you.
Oh, well, it's nice to see you. Perry is a listener of ours from Western Massachusetts. He has come out to see me perform at the Shea Theater with Monty Belmonte, guest bail of Monty Belmonte at the Shea Theater in Turner's Falls. Did you see our Judge John Hodgman show when we did that years ago, Perry, or was that before your time?
No, I did see that.
We ought to get back out there to Western Mass and do one of our shows. And Perry, you are a professional wrestler after you were a school teacher for a period of time, were you not?
I was.
And what grade did
your students know that you were also a professional wrestler?
They did. And that it was an issue. They were second graders and they couldn't wait to show me all of their cool wrestling moves, which was a nightmare.
Oh my gosh, that's amazing. Our friend James Richmuth of the brilliant sketch comedy group Casper Hauser is a psychiatrist. He's an MD. He's a psychiatrist who works with people with severe mental illness in a hospital in the Bay Area. And he would always just tell me, like, anything I can ever do so that no one knows I do comedy.
I tried to keep it from the students the entire the 2010-2011 school year. I tried to keep it from them the whole year, and maybe halfway through the year, one of the parents just happened to let slip when they were picking their kid up that not only did their child know, but they all knew. They just hadn't said anything to me.
Hey, I just have a couple of updates. Excuse me, Perry. First of all, Pond City Marxist has joined. Thank you for joining at MaximumFun.org.
They said it took them 30 seconds, maybe.
Maybe. And also, we have a little message from a member of the Max Fun family, a little message of support from Benjamin R. Harrison from The Greatest Generation. Support J.J. Ho. This show rules, as does all of Adam and Ben's Star Trek themed shows under the Greatest Gen franchise, sub franchise of the whole thing. Hey,
John,
Ben Harrison, I just got to say, Ben Harrison, why don't I hide what you said? Ben Harrison, look at this. Look at the link here. Join us. You're part of the family, for heaven's sake. Yeah, everyone wants you to join us in the chat, Ben. Okay, sorry, Jesse, you were saying?
That guy seemed vaguely threatening in his avatar. It seemed like maybe he wanted to pillory Ben, frankly.
Hey, let's find out. Okay, Kate's got to pull a stew out of the oven. Thank you, Kate, for being here.
Thank you, Kate. What I was going to say is...
We still need answers for Jennifer Marmor about the Beverly Hills, I mean, the Housewives of SLC.
That was once again my bad for not asking.
Yeah. I was once again looking at the Avatar. This is all Avatar commentary from me. I was wondering, how much of Ben and Adam's success do you think is due to talent, and how much is due to their unusual good looks? I was looking at Ben thinking, this guy's pretty handsome for a podcaster, to say nothing of a Star Trek podcaster, not to paint a broad brush over all Star Trek podcasters.
Well, I disavow these comments.
Pranica also pretty good looking.
Ben and Adam are a couple of cuties for sure, as are all fans of Star Trek.
Mm-hmm. Yeah.
But Ben, if you want to join, just or if any of you have been a litigant before, or know a litigant, or know whatever, if you're a member of the Judge Sean Hodgman family, you can go ahead and join us using the thing that was in the thing that you can see there right now. Someone says this: I'm attending this chat live from the line for the Ohio Democratic primary. All right, good. Thank you for voting.
Thank you for voting,
please. All right, Perry Von Vicious, I have to ask you a question, a series of important questions.
Okay.
Did you travel to Japan to wrestle professionally? Yes or no?
I did.
How long were you there professionally wrestling?
I was there 3 months.
And
three contiguous months?
Yeah.
Oh, wow.
How many wrestling matches did you have, would you guess?
In Japan on that visit, I had 17.
And what was your win-loss record, if I may ask?
I know I won more than I lost. I'm going to say it was probably
17 and zero.
Not quite. No.
10 and seven. Let's call it 10 and seven.
Yeah, that's actually probably not far off.
So you're a former second grade teacher, now professional wrestler from rural Western Massachusetts, who gets recruited to wrestle in Japan for 3 months. I got to imagine that has to have been the most boring and uninteresting experience of your life.
No. I mean, in a lot of ways, it was less interesting than teaching second grade.
All right.
But I would definitely say it was a lot more fun.
Yeah.
Our friend, John, we have two Japanese professional wrestler Max Fun members. It's not just Perry Von Vicious, but we have another pro wrestler member friend, Colt Cabana, who is also travels to Japan to wrestle professionally. And in fact, when I went to Mexico City, it's possible I told the story on the show, but when I went to Mexico City, Colt messaged me and he said, are you going to go to the Lucha Libre, the Mexican wrestling? And I said, I don't know. I wasn't really planning to, and he said, you know, I got the hook up there. I'll get you and your wife tickets. You got to go. It's really cool. So, I mean, I wasn't going to say no to that, right? And all of a sudden, I'm DMing in Spanish with El Guerrero Maya, a wrestler based in the Mayan Warrior, wrestler based in Mexico City. And he tells me, look, I'm going to be out of town the weekend that you're in town, but I can leave you tickets. And I was like, oh, thank you. And he says, where are you staying? I'll bring them to your hotel. And I'm like, this is too much. You don't have to worry. You don't have to bring them to my hotel. He says, it's no problem. I tell him where it is. He's like, it's right by the arena. It's no sweat. I'll drop them off. And we got to this hotel and it was like a little tiny hotel, like a 6-room hotel.
Mm-hmm.
That
is a tiny hotel.
Yeah. Very tiny. The woman who like runs the place, this like incredible, efficient, you know, super genius of hoteliery, meets us at the door,
mm-hmm.
and she gives us our keys and shows us the room. And then she says, oh, I forget. And then she goes down to the table and she grabs an envelope and she says, a man leave these for you. He says his name is El Guerrero Maya. But he's just a man.
But he's just a man.
But he's a man.
Hey, I wanted to point out that Andreen's Life says, this is the coziest thing I could fall asleep to.
Ooh.
Andreen's Life, wake up before you fall asleep. Wake up. Wake up. MaximumFun.org/join. Become a
Harry,
member
what's
if
the
not
difference?
One.
What's the step where you decide you're quitting teaching to professional wrestle? Is it like getting an offer for 3 weeks in Japan? Is it like what is the thing that makes it doable?
I mean, there was definitely an in-between step. I moved out of actively teaching and into sort of behind the scenes work at educational nonprofits, doing a lot of development, those kinds of things. But the step that brought me from full-time regular job to full-time pro wrestler, it was sort of a combination of when I had the offer to go to Japan and also when my merch sales at indie shows became so much that I didn't need the day job. I have a very silly character. I'm known as the human monster truck. And as you can probably guess, that lends itself to a lot of very nice merch designs that are very unique compared to other wrestlers. And it's very kid friendly, grown-ups like it. And because I'm a nerd and I do a lot of 3D printing, I was able to make my own toys even. And it made it so that I didn't need the day job anymore.
This is a 3D printed action figure that Perry gave me of himself.
I have to upgrade you to the version 2.0 that I now sell.
Whoa. Okay.
That is posable.
Whoa, yeah, please.
Has my name on it.
Please do. Thank you. I would love that upgrade.
Can I tell you a cool 3D printing thing? I have an old buddy. I don't know, Jennifer, you probably never knew my college friend, Carolyn Pennypacker Riggs. Mm-mm. But Carolyn, a pal of ours from college, or a pal of mine from college, her husband is a pretty acclaimed sculptor. His name's Rye Rocklin. I know he's acclaimed primarily because it's his only job. And one time I was walking through the Los Angeles County Museum of Art and I saw a piece he made. But Rye is like a real sculptor. And maybe if 3 years ago, 4 years ago, right before the pandemic, I went to an opening of his, and it was for a project that he had done where he had gotten a bunch of fruit themed mascot costumes, like apples and bananas and stuff like that, like banana suits. And he had put them on, gone into one of those super high tech 3D scanning devices, been super high tech 3D scanned head to toe, wearing the banana suit. And then he super high tech, full color, 3D printed himself in the banana suit, the size of a banana.
Perfect.
Whoa.
That's art. That's art.
Yeah.
Talk about the progression of the simulacrum, John.
This is Maximum Fun HQ saying, hi, pals. Thanks for all your support. I'm going to guess that might be Stacy, right?
It's probably Stacy. Really, Daniel?
Stacy, please join us. And earlier I posted that Eamon said, New York Times litigate, so the column in the New York Times, upgraded to $10 a month because, one, to get the pin, and two, my verdict infuriated Eamon so much that Eamon started a new career. I asked Eamon to join us here in the family meeting, and Eamon said, as soon as I get pants on. But meanwhile, Stacy, you should join too.
Yes.
bit.ly/JJHOFAMMEET. Use Chrome on a laptop or an Android device, or Safari on an iPad or an iPhone.
Perry, I'm loving this because this is the bonus content for Bullseye this year is a show that I was doing on Twitter Spaces called Hey, What's Your Job? Where I was just having people tell me what their job is. And we talked to a bunch of Bullseye listeners with amazing jobs. So talking to you, this is just my chance to go full Hey, What's Your Job on you. What's the workers' comp insurance situation when you're a professional wrestler? Like,
Good question.
What do you like? I feel like Kaiser is going to deny your application for excessive leaping if you have to go to the doctor.
Well, thankfully in Massachusetts, we have MassHealth, which is pretty nice. So I'm through them. I can't imagine they would be thrilled to know exactly what I do to my body. But I've only ever been injured to the point of needing medical care once in 16 plus years of doing this. And sadly, I was teaching at the time, and the healthcare provided was not good. So that was 2011, and not a great situation. But it's been long enough now that they've wiped all my medical debt. So
that was before you got on that Romney Care bandwagon.
Yeah, of all the people to give us great healthcare, who would have guessed?
Hey, Andrine's Life says, "I swear to God or whatever, I'm a member now. Will you let me sleep?" Yes. Good please. Night, Andrine's Life. Good thank night, you. Andrine's Life. Sleep well. Hey, here's
Stacy. Do you have a signature move?
Stacy.
I do.
Stacy, I removed you because you got to put in headphones or else we're going to get echo. Go ahead, Terry.
I do have a signature move. I lift my opponent above my head a fair bit higher than I lifted Judge John Hodgman. Yeah. I was very respectful of his distance from the ground.
I lift my
opponent above my head. I spin pretty rapidly and then kind of toss them sort of similar to how one might toss a pizza dough. I call it the Perry-Go-Round. And it was very popular in Japan. I did not know if the pun would carry, but it certainly did.
Is Japanese wrestling in a different style? Is there something different about it?
It's a little different, yeah. You know, when you generally think of American pro wrestling, it's very big characters with sort of very easy to follow theatrical stories. The Japanese wrestling is sort of based in a much more sports-based world. There's a lot more what they call kayfabe, keeping fully in character, maintaining that everything's 100% real. And as a result, they have to there's a term in wrestling, working snug, meaning that you make a lot more contact with everything, and they work very snug in Japan. Everything connects. I was training over there with some of the wrestlers, they sort of described the difference to me as when someone asks if what you do in the ring hurts, the answer is yes. Everything hurts, but nothing should injure. And that's the line they said you should walk.
Wow. That's what we try and do on Judge John Hodgman.
Hurt but not injure. We lost Stacy for some reason. I don't know what happened to Stacy. Hey, whoa, easy, buddy.
She probably went to look for headphones. I'm not trying to punch Stacy.
No, I know. I was nervous. I was scared you were gonna reach
coming for you.
Give me a little
it's
bit.
It's a long walk, tag granted.
Me. Perry Von Vicious, do you win any championship belts recently?
I did, and it is it's right here with me actually.
What's the promotion that you won the
company belt. Is called Maine Premier Wrestling.
Maine.
Wow. Yep. Yeah. I was up in Indian Island, Maine, and I won this absurdly large championship belt. For comparison,
wow.
To me, I am 6'3".
I gotta take a
yeah.
That's the right call. This. Hold that up. Give me one more second. I wanna remove this thing so I can get a better. Yeah, there we go. Here we go. Gorgeous, fantastic.
But yeah, that was just on Saturday.
So congratulations.
Thanks. It's my first championship in a couple of years.
Oh, Jesse, so. Are you getting out your championship belt?
No, I just dropped my microphone off the mic arm.
Hey, speaking of champions, we have one of Max Fun's champion employees, Stacy. Hello.
Hello.
Thank you for getting the headphones.
I'm so sorry. I didn't think to get headphones. I'm not an audio professional. I'm a business lady.
Yeah. What is your job title there at MaxFun HQ, if I may ask?
Sure. It is Director of Business Operations.
Director of Biz Ops.
Yeah, that's a cool way to say it.
And there would be, it would be fair to say that there would be no biz if it were not for the members of Maximum Fun.
Oh, for sure.
All right. Well, I think that I gave you, that was what they call a softball question. Because what we're talking about here, just to reset for a moment, there are more than 4,900 people watching the stream across all platforms at the moment. It's very exciting. Very exciting to me. And those of you who just joined may not know that this is our Max Fun Drive. It is a Maximum Fun Podcast Network's two-week drive where we celebrate and invite our members to go to MaximumFun.org/join to become members for the very first time, to maybe upgrade their membership or boost if that's possible, and otherwise directly support the podcast that they love, including the Judge John Hodgman podcast. I'm Judge John Hodgman up here in this Brady Bunch array. Over here is producer Jennifer Marmor. Over there is Jesse Thorne. We've been talking to Perry Von Vicious of professional wrestling, international professional wrestler Perry Von Vicious. And why did I just get a thumbs down? Why did it do that? There's been this weird thing. All stream, like all video stuff now cues, there are certain gestures that cue other things that happen. I don't want that turned off. Well, maybe that's wise. And director of biz ops, Stacy down there below, who, you know, Max Fun couldn't exist without Stacy, and Stacy's job couldn't exist without you all, the members, supporters of Maximum Fun.
John, so, I have a question for Stacy. Stacy, are you a worker owner? Are you a member of the Maximum Fun Co-op?
I am a worker owner. Absolutely.
What does that mean practically?
Practically, it means, I mean, so for me, it's kind of weird because I'm not a normal person. Like, I don't approach jobs in the way that, like, this is just a job, whatever. Like, I've always cared about Max Fun in this, like, weird, deep way. So when I became a worker owner, it wasn't like my mentality shifted in any way about it, but it was that, like, I actually do own it now. So instead of just sort of treating it in this way that, like, I cared about it in this big way, I act like it is part of my life. And it is kind of weird to say that I am a business owner, but it's really cool. That is not a thing that I know many people can say, especially in, like, an industry like this where there's just, you know, it's kind of unusual to own stuff, whether you're making it or working on it.
Like a lot of our employees at Max Fun, and I guess I'm included in this number as well now as a worker owner myself and an employee of Max Fun these days. Stacy came originally from the Max Fun community. So Stacy was a regular at John's. When Stacy lived in New York City, she was a super regular at a show that is of a certain kind that a certain entertainer was performing in New York. I don't know how much I'm allowed to reveal.
It was a weekly show that didn't exist.
Yeah, a weekly show that didn't exist. She was a regular there. And she is good pals with one of our first employees, Lindsay Pavlis. And may she rest in peace. She's still alive, but she doesn't work at Max Fun anymore.
Oh, my God. What are you doing to me?
Lindsay is the absolute greatest.
I was just thinking, I haven't seen Lindsay for a little. I wonder what's going on.
No, Lindsay's great. Lindsay's fine great. As far as I know. But yeah, Lindsay was one of our first employees. She was good pals with Stacy. And when Stacy moved to Los Angeles, Lindsay basically just said, hey, I know a lady that needs a job. Can we give her one?
Yeah, I got it from a tweet. She tweeted, like, is anyone looking for a job? And I was like, me. I moved with no plan. Hello.
Yeah. I mean, this is like the story of a lot of our, frankly, a lot of our best employees. You know, Christian Duenas, who is a producer, he's working right now on a new upcoming Max Fun show that is going to be really exciting. But Christian has worked on all kinds of shows at Max Fun. And Christian came to Maximum Fun because he called in a momentous occasion to Jordan Jesse Go that we found particularly charming for Jordan Jesse Go fans. It was the one where he said his momentous occasion was he just found out his grandpa's favorite genre of movie, and it was Talking Dog Movie. And we found it so charming that we, like, invited him to come hang out with us for a recording session because he had said he was in Los Angeles. So we're like, we got to meet this guy, this Talking Dog Movie guy. So we invited him. And then when we needed somebody to just do gopher stuff, like, we just needed a helper. We just needed somebody part-time to just help us with stuff because we were overwhelmed. I just said, what about that kid Christian? I know he's in school, but I bet maybe he could use a part-time job. And he ended up, Maximum Fun, I'm really proud to say, led to him dropping out of school.
He was in school to become a nurse, which was not his passion.
No, it was not what he wanted for himself in his life. Yeah. So, and he has an incredible career as a podcast producer, which he's really great at.
And thanks.
And like, I think it speaks to how deep the community of Max Fun goes that, you know, this is in part, like, I don't want to oversell it, but like, it's in part a way of being in the world, you know, like it's a piece of who we are. You know, as people, it's not just our job.
And, you know, thanks to the member supporters of Maximum Fun, the folks behind, not just the folks behind the microphones, but the folks behind the scenes, like Stacy and Christian, not only can be worker owners of the co-op, but they also have health insurance. Right. And so I'm just saying, Perry, if you ever age out of professional wrestling, I know it's very glamorous. But there are opportunities for you in podcasting. We have in the network a wrestling podcast, Tights and Fights, right? I mean, you're a listener to that one, Perry. You seem to be nodding in recognition.
I've heard some of the recent episodes. Yeah, I haven't heard the entire back catalog, but I'll get there.
Hal and all will be very sad to have missed you. I'm going to say thank you to Perry. Thank you for being here.
So
really
nice
great
to
see
you,
your face as always, and I hope all's well there out in Western Mass. And so I'm removing you from the stage, but not from my heart. And Stacy, here's Eamon. This is the guy who put his pants on. Stand by.
Thank you.
Hi, Eamon. How are you?
I'm fine now that I've got pants on. Thank you so much for letting everybody know.
You're welcome. Now, Eamon, what are your pronouns, if I may ask?
He, him.
Okay, terrific. Yes. I'm Judge Sean Hodgman. I'm the one who ruled against you in the New York Times column, Judge Sean.
You did.
Hodgman.
I think about it daily.
What was the case?
That was stealing karaoke songs.
Yeah.
This was back in 2017.
Whoa. Wowie. Zowie. Yes. You have held this grudge for a long time.
A long time. I was very bitter about the entire experience.
What?
Let me see if I can find it. Why don't you?
Do you want me to give you the thumbnail sketch?
Yes, please. If you don't mind.
Yes.
I'm here in Chicago, lovely, delightful Chicago, and I used to go to karaoke nights with a bunch of friends, and I had a very close friend who kept stealing my karaoke songs. It'd be songs that I would do fairly regularly, once or twice a month or so. And whenever he saw that I got a good reaction out of it, he would start doing the same songs before I could get them in.
Yeah.
Because you could only do them once a night.
Yeah.
And so I wrote in with a formal complaint on the subject.
You said that Zach should no longer be allowed to ever perform SOB by Nathaniel Rateliff and the Night Sweats, Hell by the Squirrel Nut Zippers, and Bad Romance by Lady Gaga. And what did I say, Eamon, that made you so
mad? My recollection, you had said that you can't own karaoke songs.
I said, Eamon is correct.
No!
I've been living a lie. There is nothing worse than having your one karaoke song that you know how to do stolen from you. And I cite as evidence, A, Marianne Ways's Christmas Party, B, the song Flagpole Sitter by Harvey Danger, which is my song, and C, Matt.
That I remember.
Yeah, a.k.a. Matt Koff, a writer and a really talented stand-up at The Daily Show, who knows what he did, is what I wrote, because he's sung it before I did. And then I said, that's it, Eamon, you're being a song hog. Pick one and call it.
That's what it was.
You can't wipe out three.
That was the issue.
Yeah.
And we did end up having a sit-down about it.
Good. So which song did you reserve for yourself?
Well, I didn't. I kind of went, so that's the part two of my message in the thing. I went the entirely different route of starting my own karaoke company so I could do whatever I want all the time.
Whoa.
Is it called Spite Productions?
Wait a minute. What had been your job before now? I forget.
I was a software developer, essentially. Website
and now you run a karaoke company.
I sure did.
Fun.
I'm going to allow you to buzz market it. What's it called?
I put on pants and also our shirt. It is pop-up karaoke here in Chicago.
Yeah, wow, that's great.
Yeah, I love any company with a polo.
Right?
You got a company polo, we're in business. That means you're serious.
That's what makes it. It's not a real business until you have a polo. Or a sticker of some kind.
Yeah, John, I have a real question for you.
Yeah.
I stole your song on our last road trip.
Mm-hmm. Well, a song that I like.
You had been thinking, I could tell you were circling it.
Which one? Kansas City Star by Roger Miller? Kansas City Star.
Yeah.
Well, you did a wonderful job.
Yeah.
Thank you.
Yeah. I didn't mind that.
Okay.
It's not like I was going to sing it. I was certainly not going to learn to play the ukulele and sing along with it. That's too hard. And it didn't matter because a couple of weeks ago, I was up in Maine and they were having karaoke in the basement and I sang it there and I got it out of my system.
I love it.
But you did a wonderful job. And I dare say, so did I. In our own ways. But I would never steal it. I would never steal that karaoke song from you. From you, Eamon, I'd steal it.
Yeah. Understood. Understood.
I
think no more of you.
What are you running? Are you running? By the way, when I talked about Flagpole City, I heard a lot of response. I was reading from another window. So who was responding to that? Whose song is
me.
That?
Me. That's also my song.
You know what? You can have it because I can't hit those notes anymore. I used to be able to.
I don't know if I ever could, but I try.
maybe on one of these Max Fun live streams that we're doing now, only during Max Fun Drive, on the Judge John Hodgman Pod YouTube channel, at times that will become regular, let's just say I'm doing them at noon every weekday. Maybe on one of these, I'll get Sean Nelson from Harvey Danger on here to talk with us. Wouldn't that be a treat? That would be a treat.
You know, John, we're doing a Jordan Jesse Go live show on Sunday at 3 p.m. Pacific, 6 p.m. Eastern.
Yeah.
Live from the Elysian Theater in Los Angeles.
Yeah.
And Renee of Can I Pet Your Dog, former Max Fun show, may it rest in peace. It is actually dead.
Not the dog.
No.
Not the dog person. Or any of the hosts.
The show. The show is dead. Okay.
Phew. Renee and I, for many years, had been threatening during one of these Max Fun Drive streaming shows to perform Suddenly Seymour from Little Shop of Horrors. And we had gotten so far in 2020 as going on Amazon and purchasing a men's size extra large leopard print dress, red pumps, and blonde wig. Because I will be performing the part of Audrey and she the part of Seymour. It's finally becoming real on Sunday.
Wow.
At 3 p.m. Pacific, 6 p.m. Eastern.
Wow.
We're going to have a great blowout Jordan Jesse Go show, and Christian from Valley Heat is also going to be performing music from Valley Heat, which I'm very excited about.
Frisbee Golf.
That's my favorite one, the Frisbee Golf song. Really made that Frisbee zing. Christian's going to do Valley Heat songs. We've got all kinds of great guests, Steve Agee and Kimberly Clark and Rob Hubel. I love Kim so much. All kinds of, I mean, all like 12 favorite Blair Erskine, like 17 favorite Jordan Jesse Go guests are going to be on the show. But the big opening number is going to be me and Renee doing Suddenly Seymour, and we'll see how it goes.
Say when that's happening again.
That's Sunday at 3 p.m. Pacific, 6 p.m. Eastern. You can watch it on the Max Fun YouTube channel, which everybody here who is watching on the Judge John Hodgman YouTube channel should make sure that they're subscribed there as well. Because among other things, Jordan and I are also every morning, other than Jordan Jesse Go mornings, which is Monday morning. So Tuesday through Sunday, we are doing a live streaming mini episode at 9:30 Pacific, 12:30 Eastern for everybody's lunch hour. So go subscribe so you get your notifications to that. Stacey, what's the Max Fun YouTube, Max Fun HQ, right? YouTube.com/@MaxFunHQ.
Correct.
Go hit that subscription so you don't miss it.
And I want to say, hang on, I lost the comment that I wanted to highlight.
Somebody said Mr. Piggy Mouse said I'm on a Suddenly Seymour diet. I suddenly see more food and I eat it.
That was pretty good. We'll put that one up.
I'm stealing that joke. Thank you, Mr. Piggy Mouse. I'm stealing that joke professionally.
Amy, do people do Little Shop songs in karaoke ever?
1,000%. I did. Just a couple nights ago.
Which one did you do?
Suddenly Seymour.
Let's hear it.
Well, you were Seymour.
Let's hear it.
I hear
a little of it.
Sometimes you did one, both. Sometimes I'm the other. Oh yeah.
What in the community they call a switch?
You get it. It's Chicago.
I'm going to say this again one more time. Let's hear it. Suddenly Seymour by Eamon.
Oh no.
Here we go. Oh yes. Oh yes.
I got no background music.
All right, that's fine. I won't.
Jesse, give me a note. How about a note?
Yeah, I have perfect pitch. That'll work well.
I assume that you did.
I'm Chevy Chase. Did you guys know Chevy Chase has perfect pitch? There's something about Chevy Chase honestly. I know for some reason.
I have a group of friends that we do karaoke with, and one of them is really adamant that we're not allowed to do musical theater songs in karaoke because they're too showy. Whenever she's not there, we're all.
What is karaoke if not showy?
Yeah, karaoke is supposed to be a modest endeavor, Jennifer.
It's not subtle.
It's not my role. Ariella, if you're watching, you're not, but putting you on blast.
Hang on, I'm working on something over here. Let's see what.
I just realized my wife is now. I just heard her laughing upstairs. I think she is now.
She's hearing it. She's watching it. Yeah,
maybe she should come down. She also sings Suddenly Seymour.
Oh,
we could do that together if she's out there.
Oh my goodness gracious.
Well, let's see. I don't know if you're going to be able to hear this. Let's see. Can you hear the music?
Yes. Oh, I can.
There we go.
Lift up your head. Wash off your mascara. Here, take my Kleenex. Wipe that lipstick away. Show me your face, clean as the morning. I know things were bad, but now they're okay. Suddenly Seymour, standing beside Jennifer, Judge John Hodgman, James, and Stacey. You don't need no makeup, but if you like makeup, you should wear it all the time. Good for you. Don't have to pretend. Oh, I like the light. Suddenly, Seymour is here to provide you sweet understanding. Seymour's your friend.
Nobody ever.
There's James.
Treated me kindly. Daddy left early. Mama was poor. I'd meet a man and I'd follow him blindly. He'd snap his fingers and me, I'd say sure. Suddenly Seymour is standing beside me. Don't give me orders.
Can't do that.
Can't condescend.
There it
can't
is.
Do that
there
while I'm leaning
is.
Over with my knee crossed.
Suddenly Seymour
is here to provide me sweet understanding. Seymour's my
tell me this feeling lasts till forever. Tell me the bad times, clean washed away.
Please understand that it's still strange and frightening. For losers like I've been, it's so hard to say.
Here we go, Jesse.
Suddenly Seymour He purified me. Suddenly Seymour showed me I can learn how to be more.
The girl that's inside you,
with sweet understanding,
with sweet understanding,
sweet understanding,
with sweet understanding,
sweet understanding.
Seymour's
my
man.
Okay, guys, I gotta go. I have couples therapy. I'll excuse myself. Goodbye, everyone.
Jesse goes off to couples therapy. Judge John Hodgman gets kicked off of YouTube. Our first year.
Well, now I need to go right now for my own.
Yeah, therapy. You better go. You better go hide too. You better go hide. You get out of here, Stacy. Jennifer, you get out of here. Great to see you. See you later. That's the Judge John Hodgman family meeting impromptu for today, Tuesday, March 19th. Hey, look, before all of my streaming accounts get taken down for what just went down there, let me just encourage you, please, to go to MaximumFun.org/join. Twitch, please, says I'm done voting in the Ohio primary, now voting with my wallet by upping my Max Fun membership. Thank you for the fun reminder. Thank you so much to everyone who watched today and was able to look. The only reason that I know these fine people is because of a wonderful podcast. It has my name in the title, but I am barely but a fraction of it. It was created by me and Jesse Thorne, Jesse's idea originally. Jennifer Marmor has been our producer for many a year now. We have a wonderful staff, including Natty Lopez, our social media director, our former social media person, Marie Barty Salinas, our editor, AJ McKeon, Daniel Spear, our video editor. So many people have gone in, you know, to make this podcast happen. And I'm a better person as a result of it. And I'm a better person as a result of the Maximum Fun community. So it is beyond my pleasure and privilege to invite people to join and become members at MaximumFun.org/join. I really hope that you will. I'll be doing more live streams during the Max Fun Drive. I don't know that anything, I don't know how we can possibly top that. The low poly Zoe does ask, will there be Get Your Pets? There will be at least one Get Your Pets. There will be Joy of Zoning. There will be other fun things that we will do. But the fact of the matter is that when, you know, this was just an idea that we had 5 seconds before we started it. It was just going to be me and Jesse and Jennifer. And all of a sudden, people that I've met through Maximum Fun and the podcast came in. And, you know, it just goes to show that this community of people on mic, people behind the scenes, and this community of listeners are just some of the most incredibly talented and interesting people. And I just really, really appreciate everybody's support. And I hope that you will join us this year in the Max Fun Drive. It goes on for 2 weeks. There are now almost 6,000 of you watching across all of the platforms. So let me just say this. Here is your call to action. If you are watching on the new Judge John Hodgman Pod YouTube channel, Judge John Hodgman Pod on YouTube, and you'd like to watch these more of these live streams, or even if you don't, please smash that like, subscribe, and get those notification buttons so that you can help spread that word, because we'll be talking about the Max Fun Drive there and elsewhere all this weekend next. But really, please, wherever you are watching, please consider becoming a member of Maximum Fun today at MaximumFun.org/join. And when you see that hashtag Max Fun Drive on any of my socials, if you're my friend, please, please share those posts that we make. Please save and share and like and algorithm them so that the word can get spread. William Loring says, this was a glorious thing to wander into on what has been a really shitty day for you. Thanks to all of you for making me laugh and smile. It's our pleasure and privilege to do so. Thank you, William. And also, I am a long time JJ Ho subscriber. And guess what? So am I. So with that, I'll say MaximumFun.org/join. I'll be doing this again at noon Eastern tomorrow. I don't know what form shape it'll take. I don't know if there will be any guests. I don't know if it'll be Get Your Pets. I'll tell you what, I'll decide. But until then, thank you for your very kind attention. MaximumFun.org /join. Please don't narc us out to ASCAP. It was, you know what I'm going to do? I'm going to do that thing they do on YouTube. It's the get out of jail free card. No copyright infringement intended. All right. I'll talk to you later. Thanks so much. We'll talk to you next time on the Judge John Hodgman live stream.